going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator, and welcome back to the original Stories from the Road. Hopefully everyone's having a good day today. And wanted to bring this back. Several people had hit me up wanting to know if I was going to bring the original format back, which, yes, I was. I was never going to do away with it. It was just that I recorded several of my live streams over on Twitch TV. Link for that is in the video description, by the way. And uploaded quite a few of the trips from that. So I had probably a good month's worth of content loaded up on YouTube. So definitely want to get most of that stuff out. But we're back today, just the original format, just me and you guys, just chatting up about SES, trucks, just kind of whatever. So we'll get into some stuff today. We are here, where are we? We are down here in Oakland, and I do have the latest version of Project West installed. As you can see, we're going to go through Yosemite National Forest, through Lee Vining. I'm pretty sure that is a new town. Then up through Carson City, and then eventually up to Elko. So this will be a multi-part trip. And the truck, we're back in the Peterbilt 389. Now this truck is private, but all the mods that are available for download are in the video description. So be sure to check that out. The mod link is always down in the video description, so be sure to check that out. Using the SCR Phantom, or Phantom, Fontaine Phantom, there we go. I can English. Let's go ahead and get started and just get right into it. Now the wheels on this truck are gonna eventually be up for a download, part of a wheel pack that I'm working on, but unfortunately over the last week or so I've not had a great deal of time to work on that. We'll kind of get into that today as we kind of roll out Oakland. It's gonna get back to the original format though, I won't lie. I'm gonna do that to you guys. And track IR might seem a little bit jittery. I've been kind of messing around with some settings on that, trying to dial that in a little bit more. And if you guys follow me over on Twitter or my Facebook page, you'll know the last couple weeks I've had some system issues. I think I finally got all that stuff sorted out. It wasn't any of the hardware. It was actually some software that was causing the issues. Might have been the Windows 10 Creators update, but it was also some utilities that came with my motherboard, it turns out. So I'm rolled back to an older version of Windows, took all the utilities out that came with the motherboard. It's like an easy tune thing for some easy overclocking and stuff like that. Got all that stuff out, and I'm running a pretty bare version of Windows right now. I just got kind of the essentials on here, which is kind of nice because it is running nice and smooth and snappy. Now, I honestly wanted to do a reinstall of Windows for a while now just to kind of get my files all organized and sorted a little bit better. Because on the old install, I had program files on a couple different drives, and I think that was kind of causing some performance issues, but all that junk is squared away. Now, like I said at the beginning of the video, and you guys probably know by now, especially if you watch my channel update video, if not, link for that will also be down in the video description. And just a quick PSA, always be sure to check out the video description, because I try to put some useful information down there for you guys. Mod links, social media links, Twitch links, all that good stuff. But I have been streaming over to Twitch, trying to do it 3 days a week. It's worked out pretty well for the most part, the exception of like Fridays, which I don't know why, but it seems like Friday is like, you know, hell to get anything going on Twitch for me. Either that's kind of when all my stuttering issues started with the system, and then last Friday it just had all sorts of just lag and stuff like that. That was on Twitch's end, wasn't really anything I could do about it. But always good information down in the video description was kind of where I was going with that, I guess. But I've been trying to do that 3 days a week over there. I'm not a partner over there, but I am an affiliate over there, which is kind of designed for smaller channels to be able to make a little bit of money over there and so forth. All that is done and set up now, so we'll test drive that out Monday. not sure when this video is going to go live. I'm recording on a Sunday, so it might go up tomorrow as well. That's kind of the goal, I guess. Been doing that, and just, it's been kind of nice, honestly. You know, it's kind of given me an opportunity to kind of step back a little bit, take a look at some things as far as what I'm doing with the channel and things like that, and just kind of, it's kind of allowed me to kind of refresh a little bit and kind of hit the reset button, if you will. You know, didn't have to worry about making and editing videos for probably about like the last month, which, I'm not gonna lie, that was kind of nice. Because you kind of do everything, you do anything, you know, for any length of time, you kind of get that burnout factor kind of going a little bit, and I was definitely getting there for sure. But that month definitely helped me out quite a bit. So I want to get back, you know, like I said in my update video, I kind of want to get back to the original format. I will still be posting trips from the live streams as well. And I'll title those a little bit differently, you know, so that we guys know, you know, hey, if it's Stories from the Road, it's this format. I'll, you know, do something different moving forward for the live streams. So that way, just everything is kind of separated out and, you know, you guys know what to expect. Then I'm going to bring the gameplay videos back. I uploaded one on Friday and, you know, I talked about doing kind of a different format for that. And I'm sure if you guys, you know, saw the video, you of course know what that is. And that's adding a live CB radio in the background. You know, instead of playing music or something like that. I've seen a couple channels do it. Where they just had, you know, live CB radio playing in the background, and I thought it was pretty cool, so I figured I'd give it a shot, and it seems like you guys reacted pretty positively to that. So that's going to be a thing moving forward, and then of course I'll have just the gameplay videos where it's just gameplay. No background audio, no commentary, just the truck going down the road and all the engine sounds and all that good stuff. Because I know in the past you guys have expressed interest in that as well. So still plan on uploading 5 days a week. It's probably going to be a pretty, it's going to be a combination of, you know, the Stories from the Road, Let's Play series, gameplay videos, and some live streams. Now, I am working on a news update video that I want to get out next week. I know I've been talking about it for about a week or so now, but it seems like about every time I get ready to sit down and work on it, you know, some more information kind of comes our way about some upcoming DLC. So I won't get into that a whole lot today because, you know, it was just kind of a small little thing, you know, we had talked about it here, but with as much stuff it has been going on in the community with the Heavy Haul DLC, the Arizona teaser video, the prefab stuff, you know, there's quite a bit to sit down and digest. Plus, I want to get into the AMA they did over on Reddit about a month ago now. There's a lot of good stuff there, so be on the lookout for that next week. But yeah, as far as, you know, like a schedule and stuff like that of, you know, hey, on Monday I'm going to upload Stories of the Road, Tuesday is going to be gameplay, I'm not going to do anything like that. It's just going to be, you know, kind of freeform, I guess. So there might be a week where I do 5 Stories of the Roads. There might be a week where I do 5 gameplay videos. It's just, you know, whatever I have, you know, kind of time to do. Because like I've said in the past, I don't do this full time. This is a hobby. Would I like to do it full time moving forward? Yeah, I would absolutely love to, man. It'd, you know, be awesome. So, but right now it's just a hobby. Over here in the left-hand lane, coming up on our turn for Yosemite. Been through this once before, prior to this update. And thought it was pretty stinking awesome, so we'll kind of see what they have in store for us here on the latest version. Yeah, this will definitely end up being at least a 2-parter, maybe even a 3-parter. Because it takes a little bit of time to get through Yosemite. You know, you look at the map and everything, and it's like, eh, it's not too far to get through there. But there's a lot of hills, a lot of turns, a lot of great scenery. As you guys look around the 389, I have changed up some stuff from when I first started using it on the live streams. Got the Cobra CB radio in here now. Got a mod that I'm experimenting with that changes the dash color to the truck color, which Bayonet over on a truck mod shop initially released something over there similar for the W900, so I kind of copied what he did and applied it to the SES 389. And also kind of look down there, actually have a gear shift in here now. This kind of makes the interior feel pretty complete with you know, the CB in here. And also, probably can't tell from that angle, but there you can kind of see actually have a CB antennas on the mirrors as well. And you can kind of see it out the mirror there, kind of below the gasket on the window. And by the time this goes live, the mod spreadsheet will be updated. I've honestly not really made a whole lot of changes to it in the last several weeks. I do have a couple different things in here now, but mainly just updates of, you know, like the Project West map and a couple little things like that. You know, the vast majority of the stuff that I use continues to be out on the Steam Workshop, which to me is just convenient as all get out, because if there's an update to the mod, if you have your Steam set up to do it, it'll automatically update it. So you don't have to worry about doing nothing, which is awesome. But if you guys have not checked out Project West, and just kind of judging by you know, people interacting on my live streams and stuff like that, a lot of you have checked out Project West. But if you have not, check this map mod out. It is awesome. Adds a whole lot of awesome scenery. I mean, you get to go through Yosemite National Forest, which is awesome. And this is the type of stuff that I really want to see from SES kind of moving forward with us, you know, some of the state DLCs and all that stuff. And you definitely got to be on your toes with your shifting, your downshifting, all that stuff going through here, because some of these hills are pretty freaking legit. I think this load is fairly 47.5, so I mean, definitely makes these hills no joke for sure. Definitely don't want to miss gears like that either, because that can screw you. I can definitely do that. Of course, I am using the N14 Select Plus 610 horsepower Cummins engine by Captain Creechbaum. This is from his 2.5 pack. This is pretty much my go-to sound mod, engine mod. Just love the way it sounds. It's got a nice deep sound to it. You know, the Jake brake sounds good. The horn sounds good. I mean, it's probably the best engine mod for my money out there. Use this in, of course, the 389. Also use it in the T680, which one of these days I'm going to get back to modding that. I know I get hit up from time to time on that. But we'll be bringing that back on the channel hopefully this week. I know I've been using the 389 quite a bit for a lot of stuff. You know, live streams, content here on the channel. Just because I put so much time into kind of get it to suit my taste. This was a mod that I got off of one of the Facebook groups that I'm on that X-Driver had originally modified. Then I took it just a little bit further, you know, changed out the steps, the tanks, worked on the light masking a little bit for the sleeper lights, which I still need to get all that sorted out, because they're still kind of doing some goofy things. This scenery is absolutely gorgeous. There's no doubt about it. A lot of lush green grass, pine trees, just amazing, amazing scenery. Really, I've got a copper hiding back there in the trees like a little bugger. but it's just super duper curvy, super duper hilly, steep hills. But it is a lot of fun for sure. Like I was saying, definitely want to get the T680 back on the channel, get the W900 back on there as well. Just want to work on a couple different skins for them, kind of get them matching with the 389 with the Eel River Transport skin. So I mean, you miss a couple gears and you're pretty much hosed. Barely three. See what I mean? I mean, this is pretty freaking, you know, hilly. We're getting quite the line of traffic behind us, but that's okay. Don't want to run this thing off the side of a mountain. Not on my list of things to do today. But like I was saying, just added some different steps, different tanks, you know, fixed up the interior a little bit, worked on the dash mod. Just a couple other things kind of here and there. Like I was saying at the start of the video, the wheel pack, I want to get that done and out. I'm just trying to figure out what exactly I want to do with it, how I want to do it. If I want to release everything all in one big pack, or just kind of release them, you know, as individual wheels. The reason I say that is because I'm using all of the rims that are initially they started life as 18 wheels of steel hauling mods, but were converted over. They were originally by Ventires, and man, the bank on this curve is awesome. Really puts this freaking engine to the test for sure. Be just a little bit quicker on my downshifting though too. But they started out life as hauling mods from Windy. There we go, man. Paid a little bit more attention to my shifting here for just a second so I get wound back up. Fourth gear is no bueno. Pretty much get a build up and just leave it in second or third. Yeah, third gear is pretty much it. But they're converted over to, or they're not really converted over, that's what I'm in the process of doing. But they were edited by a Rubber Duck, and one thing about the rims is they're not all identical. There's like your classic 10-hole Alcoas, your Peterbilt rims, which I have on here today. There are two different versions of Kenworth wheels. You have your 10-hole Kenworth wheels with like the little diamonds, and you got your big oval Kenworth wheels. You got Volvo wheels, and each of the rims are just a little bit different in how far they kind of protrude out. So not all your, you know, hubcaps, nut covers, all that stuff fit exactly the same. So I've had to go back and kind of make, not really make, but edit all the nuts and rim, or all the nuts and hubcaps and hubs and all that stuff to fit each individual wheel. So it's just a matter of trying to get all that sorted out so you guys understand what's, you know, what goes with what. You know, for example, like the big oval Kenworth wheels, you know, the nut covers for that aren't going to work on, you know, the Peterbilt wheels because, you know, you're going to have floating nuts. Nobody wants floating nuts, am I right? But, so that's kind of where that's at. But, you know, part of that is, and one reason why I might just go ahead and do, like, one big pack is I'll have to edit all the DDS files, So that way, when you guys go to choose all the individual parts for the rims, it'll clearly spell out, hey, this is for this rim only. So that way no one's complaining, hey, this isn't right, you did this wrong. Well, no, everything's right, it's just you make sure you have to choose the right accessory for the right part. I'm gonna grab a quick screenshot and you guys can watch this as well. That way we can just kind of take a quick look at the mod itself. If you guys, like I said, if you're not familiar with it, it's a pretty awesome lookout point. And just look at that. That is pretty freaking awesome. Pretty well detailed. And I know a lot of people on my streams are really wanting some of this Pacific Northwest action. As am I. And I gotta fix the exterior interior file, because that drives me nuts right there, having the blank mattress on there. Just the plain mattress with no cover or anything like that. But I digress. Just take the screenshot and move along, sir. Okay. About halfway through. Yeah, we're just past the halfway point. Now we start to go downhill a little bit. And what the heck? Did I hit like an invisible wall or something? Something, that's okay. Well, what the free holies? Yeah, there's like a freaking invisible wall here or something. Okay, that's weird. Not really experienced that before. Move it along. Kind of let this thing kind of coast down a little bit. Don't want to get going too fast. Man, that little guy's got places to go. If I remember right, it starts to straighten out a little bit. Look off to our right over there. Nice lake. Like I said, man, this just makes for some amazing scenery. You know, hopefully sooner or later that is what SES begins to work on, is some of the Pacific Northwest, because for me, that's where it's at. You know, not that I don't like what New Mexico is going to have to offer. It's going to be pretty awesome with the new prefabs, the new heavy haul cargo, which of course won't be specific to New Mexico, but I think that's going to be a big part of it. Obviously with a couple of new prefabs. But like I've said before, you know, on my live streams, I think a year or two is shaped up to be pretty awesome for American Truck Sim, for sure. You know, just with the two DLCs that we know about already. And I know a lot of people are kind of upset with how long it's taken to get stuff done, but they have went on record as to say they're not going to hurry any of this stuff. They're going to take their time and do it right the first time. And when you go back and look at when this game, when it first launched, to where it's at now, they have actually went back and corrected a lot of stuff. Of course, the rescale was the biggest part of that, but just little stuff here and there as well, you know, texture files, things like that. They've really just made the game look a whole lot better. Added some different features. You know, now we have liftable trailer axles, which is awesome. We have liftable axles on the truck, which is going to be pretty awesome for some of the heavy haul stuff, but even on a couple of the mods that are already out there now, you know, the East Genesis end dump is a prime example. You know, it's got the liftable trailer axles on it, which just make it awesome, and a couple other mods out there as well. listen to that. That is awesome. And there we go. That is Yosemite National Forest. Pretty awesome little run through there, that is for sure. A little bit of traffic to get going. Maybe if I sneak out there enough, they'll let me go. Of course, freaking AI is like, eh. And hopefully that's one thing they can kind of dial in as we progress, you know, with the game. It's kind of fix some of the, you know, goofy stuff that the AI does. Yeah, I'm sure some of the stuff's kind of coded into, you know, kind of add some realism and whatnot, which is fine, but just some of the goofy stuff that it does, like where it's going to stop, act like it's going to let you go, and then just takes off on you. Little stuff like that, hopefully they can kind of work that out of the game. Now we're coming up on Lee Vining. One of the new towns on Project West. Like a decent little town. It's got a couple motels, a couple little businesses. Looks like we got a little rest area up here where we can pull off, a little sand lot to pull off and take a little nap or whatever. Works out pretty good, depending on where you are on your trip. Getting through the National Forest back here can take a little bit of time, as we saw. Before I put Project West back in, I was just running just a vanilla map because I wanted to get a little bit more of that discovered, and I think I got just about probably 45% of that discovered, which in reality is obviously a lot more than that. But one thing I had done in the past was I had different saves, all sorts of different profiles and things like that. So, you know, on one profile I could have 40% of the map discovered, and then on another profile, I might have only had like 10% discovered. So what I've done is put everything on one profile, pretty much everything on one save. And what I'm doing now is I'm buying all the trucks that I typically use for my content and just kind of storing them in a garage instead of having different saves and different profiles for that stuff. That way, you know, I can get everything discovered and unlocked and all that good stuff on one profile. This makes it a little bit easier, a little bit more organized. Now we can get here on some straight road. Straight. And one thing I've not done that I kind of kicked around the idea of doing was someone had mentioned something about using like a tablet or something like that as a GPS, which I've not done that yet. I don't know. Seems easy enough, but If any of you guys have done that in the past or are currently doing that, leave a comment down below. Let me know how you guys like that. A couple different options that I could use. I was just kind of finding the real estate here on my desk to do that. Carson City. And another thing I need to do, I've been thinking about doing it, but every time I think about doing it, I don't, and that is taking this damn rubber spacer out on the G920 pedals. I don't know why Logitech ever thought that was a good idea. Gonna go ahead and just go on through it because we should be good. Yeah, we're good. Longer yellow light mod out on the Steam Workshop. Go and grab it if you guys don't have it. I think it's a lifesaver. Let's see. Check and see how we're doing on El Restaurant. 3 hours to go. What do we got going down here in Carson City? Looks like we got a little bit of a see, we can just, yeah. We're gonna go ahead and set that as our marker. You guys notice, you guys probably noticed that I turned pedestrians back on. I had it off for the longest time, but, you know, it's kind of livening up the game world a little bit. Stop. Ain't nothing coming that way, so we can go right on red. Watch about that time some car comes flying out of nowhere at like a Mach 12. Run down here to the motel. Truck decides it's done going backwards there. There we go. Hotel in sight. You have discovered a recruitment agency. And I've still never hired any drivers. I just really don't see any benefit to it. You know, seems like there's a lot of lacking features there. And here we are. Swinging it wide here. Well, guys, that's going to wrap it up for this part of our trip up to Elko, Nevada. If you guys enjoy the video, just give it a like and a share and comment down below. Just the interaction helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. But guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.